Hi, my name is Dan Kumo, and I'm a program manager on the Windows Core networking team. In this video, we're going to talk about the new dynamic queue scheduling algorithm used with VMMQ in Windows Server 2019. The previous implementation of VMMQ included only a static algorithm which would assign virtual machine network receive queues to logical processors. However, since the assignments were static and would not adjust to changing network conditions, CPU efficiency was wasted in low-throughput environments, and in high-throughput environments, virtual machines would not be able to reach the maximum throughput. What's more, this required complex planning, baselining, tuning, and monitoring on the part of you, the IT pro. To combat these problems, Windows Server 2019 dynamically tunes the Hyper-V host for maximum CPU efficiency and consistent virtual machine throughput. The dynamic scheduling algorithm requires no setup once a supporting driver is in place, and will auto-tune the existing workload to ensure optimal throughput is maintained for each virtual machine. Now let's take a look at our demo system. On the right-hand side of the screen, we have a virtual machine with PowerShell, and in Task Manager, you'll see the amount of network throughput we're pushing to the VM in gigabits per second. Below the virtual machine, we have a PowerShell window on the host. Here we have a performance monitor window which will show the number of received packets per second. Each bar represents a different CPU processing the packets, and the higher the bar, the more packets that CPU is receiving. In the performance monitor window at the bottom, we can see the association of received queues to specific CPUs. The height of the bar indicates which CPU the queue is currently assigned. For example, this queue is assigned to CPU 15. Whereas this queue is assigned to CPU 10. Since there's currently no traffic, the queues remain parked or spread across each of the available CPUs. Now let's kick off some network traffic and see how the system responds. In the performance monitor window at the top of the screen, you can see the system receive packets on multiple CPUs as soon as network throughput begins to progress. However, it quickly coalesced this workload to one CPU, as that's all that is required. Over time, you may see that the system adjusts the chosen CPU or expands or coalesces CPUs as necessary. Be aware, however, that this does not happen immediately to prevent queues from bouncing around too frequently. Once traffic is stopped, you'll see the cores return to their parked state.